Joining me now from Los Angeles is Rocco Pendola, columnist for TheStreet.com. Rocco, can you point to one thing and say, this was Johnson's downfall at JC Penney?
I don't think so, Jake. I think that you can certainly say, well, the sale thing and then bringing it back wasn't a good idea. And we always like to focus and hone in on one thing, but I think it's a bigger problem. I think that it's that JC Penney was in need and still is in need of a visionary, somebody who can come in and completely change retail, make the department store unrecognizable to itself, and just totally overhaul the business, because that's what it needs. Johnson isn't that guy. We think he's that guy because of what happened at Apple with their retail stores when he worked there, but I think that's a major misconception that most people share.
But he had a good reputation at Apple, and Apple obviously is a legendary company. Did people just misunderstand? They just applied Apple's success and just assumed he had something to do with it, when it's just Apple is just fantastic?
I think so. I think that what happened was Steve Jobs very clearly had a vision for retail. He knew what he wanted Apple stores to look like, from everything from design to product placement to how they were going to market them. And Ron Johnson, to his credit, to be fair, is a business person. He's a great MBA. He's a great manager. He implemented, he executed Steve Jobs' vision. We can't forget about Mickey Drexler, the chairman and CEO of J. Crew. He and Jobs worked together for years, and his input was crucial in terms of visioning the Apple retail concept. Those guys visioned it. Johnson, to his credit, implemented it. They need a visionary at J.C. Penney. That is not Ron Johnson. He thinks he's a visionary. If you hear him talk, he thinks a lot of himself. He read his own press clippings at Apple, but it just obviously didn't work out. And again, I think it's bigger than just one thing.
And lastly, Rocco, for other retailers looking at the example of J.C. Penney, other than don't hire a visionary, even if he's selling himself as a visionary, what lessons can they take from the Johnson failed experiment?
Well, don't do what you do after firing Johnson. You make the obvious move about 6 to 9 months too late, and then you bring the guy in, like Best Buy did, by installing people on their board who led the company during the time when Jeff Bezos and Amazon.com was absolutely turning retail on its ear. I mean, he crushed physical retail. So what's your answer? You bring in the same people who watched the death spiral. They were sleeping under their desk while this stuff happened. You got to look to a company like Starbucks. Howard Schultz is one of the best CEOs in the business. He treats that company like a tech company, and they're always evolving. They've been first on digital, first on mobile, and that's why they provide a great customer experience, because they continue to move with the times, and they have visionaries in place. That's the direction that all retail needs to go in, particularly the ones like J.C. Penney and Best Buy, who have had it taken to them by some of the more successful retailers.
All right, Rocco Pendola from The Street, thank you so much.